Wim, dankjewel.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much, Wim, for the introduction. Yes, this was the report that Wim referred to. But let me give you some background first. I started working with Shell in 1970, and one of my first courses, and I started working in Australia, was a course called STOP, STOP, Safety Training Observation Program. This was learning from DuPont, a company in the United States that has started its work in the area of explosives, and really developed a safety program. As you can imagine, with explosives, you have to do so, which was used widely by other industries around the world, and then the oil industry as well. Safety training observation. It says all the things that you need to do. You stop at certain times because safety is more important. You observe and you train people. And that's how my life in Shell started, with training on safety. And yes, we worked with very unsafe and unhealthy and problematic materials. Fuels in the industry are explosive and burn. And I can still recall, after 1.5 years working, that I found this one maintenance man standing under the column, an ethylene ethane spitter, which is a very explosive gas, and he stood under that smoking a cigarette. And, well, fortunately there were no leaks, nothing happened, but I took the man in my hands, walked him outside the gate, and I said to him, look, you never come here anymore. You've been told not to do this, and you never come in here anymore. And if you don't make sanctions every so now and then, show the outside world that you mean seriously that safety is an important thing, then you don't make progress in this issue. But we've still had, as a company, to make significant progress in the period since. I also had a very personal reason to get involved in this subject, particularly when the minister asked me in 2004. My father had died in 86 as a result of a medical error. And yes, the situation was then, and I can still recall in our family, he was 71 years old, he had lung emphysema, his life wasn't easy, but nevertheless, he'd never been in hospital, and after a few days in hospital, due to a medical error, he died. And you rationalized that in the family, said, yeah, but his life wouldn't have been very nice anyway with the lung emphysema, the worsening lung emphysema. But nevertheless, his situation was that he died as a result of a mistake. And when I got this opportunity to help the Ministry of Health, I took that. We spent about six, seven months with a group of people, also from the medical field. I name a few: Harry Molendijk, Ian Lysnikov. They are the authors of the booklet that Wim referred to, and Wim himself. And they helped me go through the medical hospitals and the medical system, because I'm not a medical. I've got some brothers who were involved, and brothers-in-law who were involved in the medical field as surgeons. But You come from the outside, and the first reaction, by the way, from the trade unions was, how is it possible that a man from the oil industry can talk to us about safety? We're not drums of barrels of oil. The patients are not and anyway, so there was this reluctance of accepting outside advice. And we felt in the end, and I was able to explain to the people, that also our industry took outside advice. Throughout our whole experience in the last more than 100 years, we took advice from the airline industry. When they came through the situation and upgraded their safety systems, we listened to them on how we do things. When we do big shutdowns of refineries, we take checklists now, as the airline, the pilots take checklists. So all these things, you go to another sector of society, you try to learn. And I found in my first conclusions after the first couple of months in the roaming around, visiting hospitals and talking to patients, organizations and others, that I had actually two main conclusions. One, there was an enormous dedication of people taking care of others. I mean, there was no doubt about that, that people were doing their work with great intention. And it's a sector in society which probably excels in that. But at the same time, I concluded that safety wasn't managed at all. There was no system in place. There was no thinking about, apart from the few jewels, And, and I referred already to Harry Molendijk, who started with his work. And there were some others in Katharina Ziekenhuis in Eindhoven. There were a few areas where people were indeed starting with this program, but throughout the whole, the issue was not managed. And I was then pleased to sit down with them and develop a few simple guidelines. And I'll go through with you through those simple guidelines that we then revised. And it in the end became a very simple booklet, very thin, with a few practical advices that I'm pleased to know that still people refer to every so now and then today. It's even amazing that these days people do PhDs on this subject. And there have been two or three in recent years. So at least it has got a much more serious scientific attention as well in the Netherlands, and I'm sure outside the Netherlands as well, as I've seen from the various posters outside here.